This is a long vowel sound. It's pronounced E. Now you try. Repeat after me. E. E. Now here are some words which have this sound. Fleece. See. Machine. Now you try. Repeat after me. Fleece. See. Machine. Good. For speakers of some languages, it can be difficult to tell the difference between this sound, the long vowel E, and another sound, the short vowel I. Here are some examples where you can hear the difference. Liter, litter. Cheap, chip. Feet, fit. He's, his. Peach, pitch. Sheep, ship. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. In each example, the vowel with the long sound is first. Liter, litter. Cheap, chip. Feet, fit. He's, his. Peach, pitch. Sheep, ship. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced I. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. I. I. Now here are some words which have this sound. Kit. Bid. Him. Minute. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Kit. Bid. Him. Minute. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this vowel, the short vowel I, and another sound, the long vowel E. Listen carefully to hear the difference between the two. In each pair of examples, I'll say the short sound I first. Hit, heat. Lip, leap. Sick, seek. Will, wheel. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Hit, heat, lip, leap, sick, seek, will, wheel. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced U. Now you try. Repeat after me. U. U. Now here are some words which have this sound. Foot. Put. Good. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Foot. Put. Good. That's good. This is a long vowel sound. It's pronounced oo. Now you try. Repeat after me. Oo. Oo. Now here are some words which have this sound. Goose, two, blue, group. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Goose, two, blue, group. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced eh. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Eh. Eh. Now here are some words which have this sound. Dress, head, bed, many. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Dress, head, bed, many. Good. Speakers of some languages may have difficulty telling the difference between this sound, the short vowel e, and another sound, the short vowel I. Listen carefully to hear the difference. In each example, I'll say the word with the short vowel e first. Bed, bid, medal, middle, dead, did, fell, fill, pen, pin. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Bed, bid, medal, middle, dead, did, fell, fill, pen, pin. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced uh. And to make this sound, you just relax your mouth. You try. Listen and repeat. Uh. And again, uh. In fact, this is a very common sound in English. And in many grammar words, it's the only vowel sound, such as uh, the, of, that. Let's practice these. Listen and repeat. Uh, the, of, that. Now you also get this sound in many words of more than one syllable. Listen. About, common, standard, butter. Let's practice. Listen to me and repeat. About, common, standard, butter. Good. You could say that the vowel a is the most important vowel in English. In fact, it's so important it has its own name. It's called John. No, not really. It's actually called schwa. Schwa, which is pretty strange when you think about it, because the word schwa doesn't have the schwa sound a in it. So why is this sound so important? Well, it's a very natural sound for English speakers, and it's actually the most frequent sound in English. It appears in just about every word with more than two syllables, and it's very important for getting the stress and rhythm of English right. Schwa is usually in unstressed syllables. Let's have a look at some examples. Accuse, banana, father, camera. Okay, now you try. Listen and repeat. Accuse, banana, father, camera. Now, as well as being a part of many words, schwa can also be the pronunciation for a whole word itself. And to show you this, I'm going to need an assistant.
A cup of tea.
Thank you. An ordinary cup of tea. But listen to what happens when I say the words a and of naturally. A cup of tea. A cup of tea. The words a and of become schwa, a. Now you try, listen and repeat after me. A cup of tea. A cup of tea. Good. Now this is such a natural and common way to pronounce cup of that in British English the word cuppa actually means a cup of tea. And after all that, I'm really looking forward to my cuppa. Actually, what I really fancy is a piece of cake. This is a long vowel sound. It's pronounced Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Here are some words which have this sound. Nurse, stir, learn, refer. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Nurse, stir, learn, refer. Good. This is a long vowel sound. It's pronounced or. Now you try. Repeat after me. Or. Or. Now here are some words which have this sound. Thought. Law. North. War. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Thought. Law. North. War. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced ah. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Ah. Ah. Now here are some words which have this sound. Trap. Stamp. Back. Lap. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Trap. Stamp. Back. Lap. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced ah. Now you try. Repeat after me. Ah. Ah. Now here are some words which have this sound. Strut. Mud. Love. Blood. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Strut. Mud. Love. Blood. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this sound, the short vowel a, and another sound, the short vowel a. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'll say the word with the vowel a first. Uncle, ankle, bunk, bank, butt, bat, cup, cap, swum, swam. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Uncle, ankle, bunk, bank, butt, bat, cup, cap, swum, swam. Good. This is a long vowel sound. It's pronounced R. Now you try. Repeat after me. R. R. Now here are some words which have this sound. Father. Start. Hard. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Father. Start. Hard. Good. This is a short vowel sound. It's pronounced O. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. O. O. Now here are some words which have this vowel sound. Lot. Odd. Wash. Now you try. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Lot. Odd. Wash. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced ear. Did you notice how the shape of my mouth changed from the beginning to the end of the sound? Listen and watch. Ear. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Ear. Ear. In fact, this is the same as the word ear, which you hear with. Now here are some words with this sound in them. Near, hear, weary. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Near, hear, weary. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced A. Did you notice how my mouth changed shape? A. Now you try. Listen, watch, and repeat. A. A. Now here are some words that have the A sound. Face. Day. Break. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Face. Day. Break. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this diphthong A and the long vowel E. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the diphthong A first. Ate, eat, faced, feast, great, greet, mate, meet. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Ate, eat, faced, feast, great, greet, mate, meet. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced ur. Did you notice how my mouth changed shape from the beginning of the sound to the end? Ur. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Ur. ua. Now here are some words which have this sound, tour, pure, cure. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Tour, pure, cure. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the word to the end. It's pronounced oi. Did you notice how my mouth changed shape? Watch. Oi. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Oi. Oi. Now here are some words which have the oi sound. Choice. Noise. Boy. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Choice. Noise. Boy. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced O. Did you notice how my mouth changed shape? Watch. O. Now you try. Listen, watch and repeat after me. O. O. Now here are some words that have the O sound. Boat. Show. No. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Boat. Show. No. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between the diphthong O and the long vowel OR. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the diphthong O first. Coat, court, dough, door, sow, saw, flow, floor. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Coat, court, dough, door, sow, saw, flow, floor. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced air. Did you notice how my mouth changed from the beginning to the end of the sound? Watch. Air. Now you try. Air. Air. Now here are some words that have the air sound. Square. Fair. Pair. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Square. Fair. Pair. Good. Some learners may find it difficult to tell the difference between this sound, air, and another sound, the short vowel, a. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'm going to say the word with air first. Dared, dad. Glared, glad. Mary, marry. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Dared, dad. Glared, glad. Mary, marry. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced I. Did you notice how the shape of my mouth changed? Watch. I. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. I. I. It's the same as the word for I. Now here are some words with this sound in them. Price. High. Try. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Price. High. Try. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape the mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. It's pronounced ow. Now, did you notice the shape of my mouth? Ow. Now you try. Watch, listen, and repeat. Ow. Ow. Now, here are some words that have the ow sound. Mouth. Now. Foul. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Mouth. Now. Foul. Good. Now, speakers of some languages may find it difficult to tell the difference between the diphthong ow and another diphthong o. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the diphthong ow first. Couch. Coach, clown, clone, loud, load, found, phoned. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Couch, coach, clown, clone, loud, load, found. Phoned. Good. This is a diphthong, a double vowel sound. The shape my mouth makes changes from the beginning of the sound to the end. To show you this one, I need an assistant.
Ow!
Good. This is a voiceless sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the words pack and pan, in the middle of the words copy and happen, and at the end of the word hop. Also at the beginning and end of the word pop. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Pack. Pan, copy, happen, hop, pop. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this voiceless sound and its voiced partner, which you can hear at the beginning of the word back. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiceless sound first. Pack, back, punch, bunch, pump, bump, pull, bull. Could you hear the difference? Now let's look at the difference. Watch the piece of paper. Pack, back, punch, bunch, pump, bump, pull, bull. Did you see the piece of paper moving? The big puff of air forces the paper to move, and you can feel that with your hand. Pack, back. Now you try. Let's go through the words again. Listen and repeat after me. Pack. Back. Punch. Bunch. Pump. Bump. Pull. Bull. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the words back and bag, in the middle of the words hobby and habit, at the end of the word job, and at the beginning and end of the word bob. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Back. Bag. Hobby. Habit. Job. Bob. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this voiced sound and its voiceless partner, the one that you can hear at the beginning of the word pack. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiced sound first. Back, pack, bear, pair, cab, cap, symbol, simple. Could you hear the difference? Now let's look at the difference. Watch this. Back, pack, bear, pair, cab, cap, symbol, simple. Look again. Back, pack. With the voiceless sound, there's a big puff of air. You can feel it with your hands. Back, pack. Now let's try the words again. Listen carefully and repeat. Back. Pack. Bear. Pair. Cab. Cap. Symbol. Simple. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word tin, in the middle of the word button, at the end of the word get, and at the beginning and end of the word tight. In English, we make this sound with the tongue behind the teeth here. Now let's try. Listen and repeat after me. Tin, button, get, tight. Okay. Now you may find it difficult to hear the difference between this voiceless sound that you can hear at the beginning of the word tin and its voiceless partner that you can hear at the beginning of the word din. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiceless sound first. Tin, din, two, do, town, down, eight, aid, bet, bed. Did you hear the difference? Perhaps you can also see the difference. Watch this. Tin, din. Did you notice how the puff of air at the beginning of tin makes the paper move? Watch. Tin. Din. Now let's practice these examples. Listen carefully and repeat. Tin. Din. Two. Do. Town. Down. Eight. Aid, bet, bed. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word dame, in the middle of the word ladder, at the end of the word odd, and at the beginning and end of the word did. In English, we make this sound with the tongue behind the teeth here. So let's practice. Listen and repeat. Dame. Ladder. Odd. Did. Okay. You may find it difficult to hear the difference between this voiced sound that you hear at the beginning of the word dame and its voiceless partner that you hear at the beginning of the word tame. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiced sound first. Dame, tame, doom, tomb, medal, metal, heard, hurt. Did you hear the difference? You might be able to see the difference. Look. Dame, tame, dame, tame. In English, we say the sound at the beginning of the word tame with a big puff of air. Look. Dame, tame. Let's practice. Listen and repeat after me. Dame, tame, doom, tomb, medal, metal, heard, hurt. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word choke, in the middle of the word teacher, at the end of the word match, and at the beginning and end of the word church. Did you notice the shape of my mouth? Look. Church. Church. Now let's practice. Listen and repeat after me. Choke. Teacher. Match. Church. Okay. You may find it difficult to hear the difference between the voiceless sound that you hear at the beginning of the word choke and the voiced sound that you hear at the beginning of the word joke. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'll say the word with the voiceless sound first. Choke, joke, chunk, junk, rich, ridge, lunch, lunge. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Choke, joke, chunk, junk, lunch, lunge, rich, ridge. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word joke, in the middle of the word lodger, at the end of the word bridge, and at the beginning and end of the word judge. Did you notice the shape of my mouth? Judge. Judge. Now let's practice. Listen and repeat after me. Joke. Lodger. Bridge. Judge. Okay. You may find it difficult to hear the difference between the voiced sound that you hear at the beginning of the word joke and its voiceless partner that you hear at the beginning of the word choke. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'll say the word with the voiced sound first. Joke, choke, junk, chunk, lunge, lunch, surge, search. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Joke. Choke. Junk. Chunk. Lunge. Lunch. Surge. Search. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word came, in the middle of the word lucky, at the end of the word sick, and at the beginning and end of the word clock. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Came. Lucky. Sick. Clock. Okay. Now it may be difficult to hear the difference between this voiceless sound that you hear at the beginning of the word came and its voiced partner that you hear at the beginning of the word game. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiceless sound first. Came, game, back, bag, cage, gauge, calories, galleries. Now, if you can't hear the difference, you might be able to see the difference. Watch. Came, game, came, game. In English, we say the voiceless sound with a puff of air. Look. Came. Now let's practice. Listen to the examples and repeat after me. Came. Game. Back. Bag, cage, gauge, calories, galleries. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word glue, in the middle of the word struggle, at the end of the word bag, and at the beginning and end of the word gig. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Glue. Struggle. Bag. Gig. Okay. Now it may be difficult to tell the difference between this voiced sound that you hear at the beginning of the word glue and its voiceless partner that you hear at the beginning of the word clue. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiced sound first. Glue, clue, ghost, coast, log, lock, pig, pick. Now, did you hear the difference? You might be able to see the difference. Watch. Glue, clue, glue, clue. Let's try again. Listen and repeat after me. Glue, clue, ghost, coast, log, lock. Pig. Pick. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word fat, in the middle of the word coffee, at the end of the word rough, and at the beginning and end of the word fluff. Now, did you see how I make this sound? Watch my lip and my top teeth. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Fat. Coffee. Rough. Fluff. Okay. You may find it difficult to tell the difference between this voiceless sound, f, and its voiced partner, v. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiceless sound first. Fan, van, leaf, leave, off, of, rifle, rival. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Fan, van, leaf, leave, off, of, rifle, rival. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word very, in the middle of the word heavy, at the end of the word move, and at the beginning and end of the word verve. Did you see how I make this sound? Watch my lip and my top teeth. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Very. Heavy. Move. Verve. Okay. You may find it difficult to tell the difference between this voiced sound, v, and its voiceless partner, f. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the voiced sound first. Vault, fault, believe, belief, live, life. Now you try. Listen again and repeat. Vault, fault, believe, belief, live, life. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this voiced sound at the beginning of very and another voiced sound, which you can hear at the beginning of berry. Listen. Very, berry. If you can't hear the difference, look at the difference. Watch my lips and teeth. Very, berry. When I say very, my teeth are touching my lip. Very. When I say berry, my lips are tight together. Berry. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I shall say the word with the sound v first. Very, berry. Vet, bet. Vote, boat. Vowel, bowel. Now you try. Listen again and repeat. Very. Berry. Vet. Bet. Vote. Boat. Vowel. Bowel. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. It's pronounced Now, did you notice that I make the sound by sticking my tongue out just a little bit and blowing air between my tongue and my top teeth? Now you try. Watch and listen. Again. You can hear the sound at the beginning of the words thin, throw, and thumb. In the middle of the words author and healthy, and at the end of the words birth and path. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Thin. Throw. Thumb. Author. Healthy. Birth. Path. Good. This is a voiced consonant. It's pronounced th. Now, did you notice how my tongue sticks out just a little bit as I say it? Watch. Th. The sound comes from between my tongue and my top teeth. Th. Now you try. Watch, listen, and repeat. Th. Again. Th. You can hear the sound th at the beginning of the words then, this, there, and that, in the middle of the word other, and at the end of the word smooth. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Then. This. There. That. Other. Smooth. Good. This is a voiceless consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word soon, in the middle of the word mister, at the end of the word hiss, and at the beginning and end of the word cease. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Soon. Mister. Hiss. Cease. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between the voiceless sound s and its voiced partner z. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'll say the word with the voiceless sound s first. Hiss, his, course, cause, place, plays, gross, grows. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Hiss. His. Course. Cause. Place. Plays. Gross. Grows. Okay. This is a voiced consonant. You can hear it at the beginning of the word zero, in the middle of the word music, at the end of the word buzz, and in the middle and at the end of the word roses. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Zero. Music. Buzz. Roses. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between the voiced sound z and its voiceless partner s. Listen carefully to hear the difference. For each example, I'll say the word with the voiced sound z first. Buzz, bus, rise, rice. Zip, sip, lazy, lacy. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Buzz, bus, rise, rice, zip, sip, lazy, lacy. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. It's pronounced sh. This is the sound you make if you want someone to be quiet. Sh. Did you notice the shape of my lips? Watch. Sh. Now you try. Listen, watch, and repeat after me. Sh. Now let's look at some words with the sound sh in them. It's found at the beginning of the words ship and sure, in the middle of the word nation, at the end of the word fish, and at the beginning and end of the word shush. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Ship. Shore. Nation. Fish. Shush. Good. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between the sound sh and the consonant s, especially at the beginning of words. Did you notice the difference in the shape of my lips? Watch. Sh, s. Listen carefully to the following examples. For each example, I'll say the word with sh at the beginning first. Ship. Sip, show, so, shy, sigh, chauffeur, sofa, shock, sock. Now you try. Listen, watch, and repeat after me. Ship, sip, show, so, shy, sigh, chauffeur, sofa, shock, sock. Good. This is a voiced consonant. It's pronounced zh. Did you notice the shape of my lips? Zh. The sound zh can be found in the middle of the words leisure, pleasure, and vision, and at the end of the word beige. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Leisure. Pleasure. Vision. Beige. Good. This is a consonant sound. It's pronounced m. I make this sound by closing my lips and letting the sound come through my nose. M. I can even feel my nose vibrating. You try. M. You can hear this sound at the beginning of the word more, in the middle of the word hammer, at the end of the word some, and at the beginning and end of the word mime. Now you try. Listen and repeat. More. Hammer. Some. Mime. Good. It may be difficult to hear the difference between this sound, n, and two similar sounds, the sound n that you hear at the end of the word sun, and the sound n that you hear at the end of the word sung. Now listen carefully and watch the shape of my mouth as I say these words. Sum, sun, sung, rum, run, rung. Now you try. Listen and repeat after me. Some. Sun. Sung. Rum. Run. Rung. Good. This is a consonant sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the word nice, in the middle of the word funny, at the end of the word sun, and at the beginning and end of the word none. In English, we make this sound with the tongue behind the teeth. N. And when you make this sound, you should be able to feel a vibration in your nose. N. Now let's practice. Listen and repeat after me. Nice. Funny. Sun. None. Okay. It can be difficult to tell the difference between this sound, n, and another similar consonant, n, which is made much further back in the mouth. Listen to these examples. Sun, sung. Can you hear the difference? Let's try. You repeat after me. Sun, sung. Sun, sung. Here are some more examples. Listen first. Pin, ping. Ran, rang. Thin, thing. Wind, winged. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Pin, ping. Ran, rang. Thin, thing. Wind, winged. Okay. This is a consonant sound. Now in English, you will never find it at the beginning of a word because it only comes at the end of a syllable. So you find it in the middle of the word anger and the middle of the word thanks and at the end of the word rung. Now we make this sound towards the back of the mouth. Mm. And if you do this sound correctly, you can feel a vibration in your nose. Mm. Now let's practice. Listen to these examples and repeat after me. Rung. Anger. Thanks. Okay. Now it can be difficult to hear the difference between this sound, ng, and another similar consonant, n. Listen carefully. Rung, run, rung, run. Now ng is made at the back of the mouth and n is made behind the teeth. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Rung, run, rung, run. Now let's have some more examples. Listen first. Tongue, ton. Wing, win. Robbing, robin. Singer, sinner. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Tongue, ton. Wing, win. Robbing, robin. Singer, sinner. Okay. This is a voiceless consonant. It makes very little sound because it's really just your breath. You can hear it at the beginning of the word hear. You can also hear it at the beginning of the words hot and hello, and in the middle of the word ahead. In English, you will never hear this sound at the end of syllables and words. You only find it at the beginning of the syllable. Now let's listen to some examples. Here, hot, hello, ahead, height, hedge, how. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Here, hot, hello, ahead, height, Hedge. How. Okay. This is a consonant sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the word light, in the middle of the word valley, at the end of the word bell, and at the beginning and end of the word level. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Light. Valley. Bell. Level. Okay. Speakers of some languages may find it difficult to tell the difference between this sound, l, and another consonant, r. Now listen carefully to hear the difference between the following two words and watch the position of my mouth. Light. Right. Light. Right. I make the l sound with the front part of my tongue behind my teeth, and I make the r sound by making my lips come out and pulling my tongue back. R. Now listen to some examples and watch the shape of my mouth. Lead, red, clash, crash, climb, crime, lice, rice, lock, rock. Now you try. Listen again and repeat after me. Lead, red, clash, crash, climb, crime, lice, rice, lock, rock. Okay. In English, l at the beginning of the syllable is a bit different from l at the end of a syllable. Listen carefully. Leaf, feel, leaf, feel, and let, tell, let, tell. Did you hear that little difference? Listen again. L, l, l. Now for some speakers of English, this can change the vowel a little bit. Listen again. Loaf, foal, loaf, foal, and lute, tool, lute, tool. Now this can actually make the l sound disappear at the end of a syllable. So I can say pal or pow. I can say pill or pill. Mile, mile. Milk, milk. Cold, cold. So be careful, there's a bit of a difference. This is a consonant sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the words right and wrong, and in the middle of the words sorry and arrange. Now watch my mouth while I'm saying this sound. My lips come out and I pull my tongue back. Rrr. Okay, let's practice. Repeat after me. Right. Wrong. Sorry. Arrange. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this sound, r, and another consonant, l. Now listen carefully to the following examples and watch the shape of my mouth. For each example, I'll say the word with the sound r first. Wrong, long. Royal, loyal. Misread, misled. Pirate, pilot, pray, play. Now let's practice. Listen carefully and repeat after me. Wrong, long, royal, loyal, misread, misled, pirate, pilot, pray, play. Okay. Now, in standard Southern English, you won't usually hear this sound at the end of a syllable or word. Listen to the following examples. Car, card, board, hear, heard. Okay, let's practice these. Listen and repeat. Car, card, board, hear, heard. Now you will hear this sound at the end of a word if the following word begins with a vowel. Listen to the following two sentences. This is my car. My car is blue. In the first sentence, this is my car, you don't hear the r sound because it's at the end of the sentence. In the second example, my car is blue, the following word is begins with a vowel. So let's practice this. Car. Car is. My car is. My car is blue. Okay. This is a consonant sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the words wet and one and when, and in the middle of the word beware. You can also hear it in the words quick and queen. Now let's practice. Listen and repeat. Wet. One. When. Beware. Quick. Queen. Okay. For speakers of some languages, it may be difficult to tell the difference between this sound, which you find at the beginning of the word wet, and another sound, which you find at the beginning of the word vet. Now listen carefully as I say these words, and watch my lips. Wet, vet, wet, vet. Now you try. Listen, watch, and repeat. Wet, vet. Now let's look at some more examples. Listen first and watch my lips. Worse, verse, while, vile, west, vest, wary, vary. Now you try. Listen and repeat. Worse, verse, while, vile, west, vest, wary, vary. Okay. This is a consonant sound. You can hear it at the beginning of the words yet, use, yellow, and useful. Now some consonants also take this sound when they come before the vowel oo. Listen. Beauty, few, cute, accuse. Now let's practice. Listen and repeat. Yet, use, yellow, useful, beauty, few, cute, accuse. Okay.